although I'm presenting my portfolio, and he's got the handheld stuff.
Oh, I already gave him out.
Okay. I didn't know. When you first bring up my portfolio, you see the flash. I wanted something different on my home page to catch somebody's eye. Originally, I had music going on to it. I couldn't, the guy for me remembered how to shut it off, so I just took it off. The logo is one of my drawings that I took into Photoshop and just added color to it. And then if you go to the About Me page, please. And then just tells you a little bit about myself. I didn't want to go into too much detail about me. The picture is one of the pictures that I originally took. It was in color. It's an action that you can do in Photoshop to give it the effect. If you notice, there's four different colors on top of the image. Hold on. When I'm done, I want to worry about working with. I enjoy working with Flash and Photoshop. I'd rather do images and graphics and stuff than put on my phone. This is the work that I've done in Photoshop. Again, if you click on the different images, it will take you to a bigger one. Again, this is, if you notice the difference. There's just a slight difference in the two different parts. This one here is another one. If you notice, the picture itself was off. Took it into Photoshop and enhanced it. The different colors in the pictures themselves and the crack is gone. This one here, this is was actually to me one of the hardest ones I did because you had to add different layers. You had more different layers. This is the original one. If you notice, there's more into this one. And then if you slightly see the little watermark there. And then again, here's the postcard. Just taking it into Photoshop and adding different effects to it. This one here was a logo, the logo I did for the mall that we did for 242. This one here, it's a gradient background with the green and the dark pink or purple color with two different paint brushes that you can use within it to give the leaf and the star effect. And then you have the wording. This one here I am like so proud of. I didn't have the money to buy the limitations, so I decided to take my degree one step further and made my own. This here, the background, Mr. Loris wanted us to do a mock DeVry logo. And since I figured I'm graduating, I'll put the graduation cap in it and put the DeVry over that and just, the original is actually darker. I just lightened up the opacity of it so it looks more that it's in the background and not so prominent. And then just added the mobile graduation information that you wanted. Again, this is another logo that I did for the ball that we were creating. It's a light blue with a light pink gradient. And since the butterfly is another one of my drawings, I like butterflies. And then it's actually butterfly shop. I use the butterfly as the symbol for butterfly and then this shop. This one here was a little harder for me to figure out what to do. The actual concept of this here, I actually got off of a ring that I saw online. I like the concept of the intertwined. And so I used that and then That's the mall logo for the... This mall that we made. This is all the flash work that I've done. This here, different images come in, and then at the end it tells you where the action was.
That second one doesn't, it, for some reason it takes you to a, it's trying to find the domain, and because you have a www there instead of, click just a little bit on the top side of it or on the picture of it down there on the tube. Yeah, click on the tube if you can. No. Yeah, see, when you click on the www, it's trying to go there instead.
Okay.
So yeah, you need to change the action on that a little.
Okay. And this one is also done in Flash. For some reason, the sound wasn't. Some of the sound on mine is not working. I don't know why. But there was actually you can actually, in the original one, you can actually hear the rumble of the cars. And then the is for your double identity. This one here, I actually enjoyed doing because you're using the thumb tool to make the things move. This one here, again, use the phone tool. My original one, unfortunately got lost when my computer went down, but my original one I had more than this movie. This is more of a movie. This is, again, working with Flash, and each individual...
Good day! My name is Paul Smith. I'm the original...
Each individual thing has its image and movie, and if you click on the sounds, each one of the sounds are different. That was one of them that was getting involved with this one. This one is really fun. There's supposed to be images in there. I've tried several times getting the images to show, but the words, it's a template made in Flash. Each individual thing shows them. This here is actually a mock website, rather than the actual things work. I couldn't get them to work properly. So, I was still fighting with that at 2 o'clock this morning trying to get it to work. And then, of course, we have our little spacing that any kid can memorize, but I have my 2-year-old who's just working.
You can turn the sound back on for that one there, Michael.
Work correctly, and I do notice some of it's still not. But the reason why I chose the work that I've done is because I thought they were my best pieces that I've worked on, especially with my Photoshop stuff that I've created. Here soon I'll probably be adding more to it as I do more experimenting with Photoshop and Flash.
Okay.
Oh, and this here is actually the lighthouse logo that we did for the restaurant, that I did for my restaurant. It's another one of my drawings I took into Photoshop, and I wanted to give it that old-time feel. Because, you know, if you're walking down the beach, and more than...
Do you have any samples of your websites, projects that you've done?
I didn't want to...
Didn't want to include them?
Okay.
Because I don't really want to work on websites.
Okay.
I'd rather just work on graphics for the websites.
Okay.
And then with my resume, When I did this, I took my objective first, so that's the first thing you should see. And then you click on the PDF, and it will actually bring you to the copy of the recipe. Then the contact me. I just want to go and put my email address on there in case some bot decides to run and go without email. So you actually click on email me, it opens up
Outlook,
and you get it that way. The images log in from the About Me page. Are there any questions?
Click on the student sample there. Go to her other. Do you have links to what? How do you do your other ones? Now go to the next one for her.
All of them pretty much link back to
okay.
The main one. The C panel wasn't working for me to actually fix the domain.
That's fine. That's fine.
I couldn't get into the C panel from this one to fix it. I'm still waiting for them to fix that.
Okay. But from at home you can.
No.
Oh, can. Okay. No.
I sent in a trouble ticket Friday and they haven't gotten back with me.
Okay, let's talk about that. Okay, good job. Any questions for Linda on her portfolio? I think you did a good job. You did a good representation of what you want to go into. You stressed the two areas. Even though you may not want to go into website or website design, I think I would include a few of the website, at least the team projects that you were part of. And the reason I would stress the team project, putting a couple of your team projects up there on your portfolio, is to show that you are capable and have and will be able to work as part of a team, regardless of whether it's on photo respiration, whether it's on a flash project. You want to be able to show that you did in fact work as part of a team. You may want to not. That's the third part, the last third. Websites created as a team. Don't say websites created. Say team project websites or something. So, because you don't want to stress that you don't want to create websites, which is fine, but you do want to stress that fact that you've learned how to and have the ability to work on a team.
Okay.
Good job. Thank you. Yes.